Okay, so the next speaker is Alexander, and he's going to explain us a better than 3n circular bound for an explicit function.
Thank you for the introduction. Yeah, my name is Sasha Glavnyov, and I want to present a new circuit lower bound, which is a joint work with Magnus Findt, Edward Hirsch, and Valery Kulikov. So the main question in this line of research is to prove lower bounds on computations. And the simplest computation model is so-called straight line program. Think that all your variables are Boolean variables, then straight line program is just a program with no if statements, with no branching. And it naturally corresponds to a Boolean circuit. And formally speaking, this is a circuit where you have n Boolean inputs. You also have constants 0 and 1 for free. And each gate can compute an arbitrary binary Boolean function. So we do not pose any restrictions on fanouts nor on depths. So again, all fanins are 2, and fanouts and depths are unbounded. Already in 1949, Shannon proved that almost all Boolean functions require circuits of exponential size. Later, Lupanov showed that the tight upper bound, that every function can be computed by a circuit of size like 2 to the n over n. But the main challenge here is to prove a lower bound for an explicit function, that is, for a function from a reasonable complexity class, like NP or P, something like that. So here's a list of known explicit lower bounds. In Klos and Maloshev in the 60s proved that a symmetric polynomial of degree 2 cannot be computed by a circuit of size smaller than 2n. Then Schnorr proved essentially the same bound for the mod 3 function. Paul in 1977 proved that the so-called indexing function cannot be computed by a circuit of size 2.5. And here you should think of X as a bit string of length n and a and b as bit strings of length log n. Then you just take X sub a and XOR it with X sub b. Then Stockmeyer proved the same lower bound for almost all symmetric functions. And finally, Blum in 1984 proved a lower bound of 3n for a slight modification of the indexing function. 5 years ago, Dimenkov and Kulikov proved essentially the same bound, but for a very complicated function called affine dispersor. And now we slightly improved this bound for affine dispersors. But still, we're like children playing in sandbox. Our goal is to prove super polynomial bounds, or at least like super linear bounds, and this is the best what we can do. And I want to quote here Saxena and Sushandri, their work on depth 3 circuits, but this is relevant to our model too. They say like, this question is still open. This may seem depressing. Well, it is. And just to show you a plot of the known lower bounds, like from 60s, we know lower bound of 2n. From 70s, we know lower bound of 2.5. And then from 80s, 3n. And this is like our latest achievement. Like this. So essentially, the only method we know, the only method we use in proving lower bounds in this unrestricted depth model is gate elimination. And gate elimination normally has 3 steps. Say you want to prove a lower bound of 3n. You fix some class capital F of functions, and that's what you normally do. You say that for any circuit that computes a function from this class, you can find some substitution. Say you can substitute a constant to a variable, such that you can eliminate at least 3 gates from the circuit. Like your new function, your new circuit won't need the 3 gates to compute the new function. Then ideally, you would say that your new function, which probably depends on n minus 1 variables, still belongs to your class. And then you can say, OK, then I can repeat the steps, because I'm still in the same class. And if you do it almost n times, each time eliminating 3 gates, then total, you eliminate almost 3n gates, thus your original circuit was of size at least 3n. Here's an example of gate elimination. Say I want to assign 1 to x1. Then g5 would compute just negation of g3. So I don't need this gate g5 in my circuit anymore. I just can fit g6 by negation of g3. And to make it a normal circuit without any like negations on the wires, I can just flip a bit here. I mean, change the function in computing in G6. Okay, but ideally to prove even like 3n lower bound, I would like to eliminate 3 gates. That's how it normally works. One more example. I assign 0 to x3, then again G1 computes just x2, so I can eliminate G1. And also I feed G2 by 0. So this end becomes 0, and it also kills the next gate because it's fed by constant. So I succeed, I eliminate 3 gates. Unfortunately, it's not always possible to eliminate 3 gates using this kind of substitution. What is possible, what is easy to show, is that if I could make more general substitutions, if I could substitute linear functions instead of constants to my variables, then I could actually easily eliminate 3 gates each time. But what function would this lower bound be for? This leads us to the definition of affine dispersor. So affine dispersor is a Boolean function that, affine dispersor for dimension D is a Boolean function that is not constant on any affine subspace of dimension at least D. Equivalently, you can say that affine dispersor does not become constant after any set of n minus d consistent linear restrictions. And this is exactly what we wanted, like on the previous side. We wanted to make linear restrictions rather than just constant restrictions. And luckily, affine dispersors let us do it. It is known that the class P contains affine dispersors for sublinear dimensions. The first construction was obtained by Ben Sasson and Kaparty a few years ago. So this slide just says that actually we can easily prove a lower bound of 3n minus little of n. Indeed, we can each time eliminate 3 gates making an affine substitution, and there exists a function in P that does not become constant after almost n substitutions of this form. But it also can be shown that using this idea, you cannot prove a stronger bound. You cannot improve the lower bound of 3n minus little of n. So we have to use some new ideas, some new techniques to prove a stronger lower bound. So our goal is to prove a lower bound of 3.01n for the same function, for fine dispersor. Here are the three main techniques that we use. I will discuss them briefly in the next slide. So the first one is delayed linear substitution. The second one is cyclic circuits, and we also introduce quite complicated circuit complexity measure. So the first one, delayed linear substitutions. Again, it's not enough just to make standard like constant substitutions or even linear substitutions to variables. So sometimes we also make these quadratic substitutions. But each time when we make it, we guarantee that by the end of the gate elimination process, we will substitute one of these like quadratic variables by constant, which will turn the quadratic substitution into a normal linear restriction. So we guarantee that in the end, we will have only linear restrictions. But in the process, we will sometimes make quadratic substitutions. The second new ingredient of our proof is cyclic circuits. In our proof, we don't know how to stay in the class of normal circuits. So we have to allow for some cycles. But in general, cyclic circuits can be quite messy. It's not even clear how to evaluate such a circuit. So we allow only for very nice cycles. First of all, we say that every cycle in our circuit contains only XORs, only linear gates. And the second restriction is that if you write a linear system for your cyclic circuit, then the correspondent matrix has full rank. This means that for each assignment to the variables, you have a unique assignment to the gates. So this means the circuit is nice. You can actually evaluate it, just not in a regular way. You can evaluate it by solving some linear system. Okay, and the last ingredient we used in our proof was a carefully chosen circuit complexity measure. I mean, ignore the constants. This is just a solution to some linear programs. So what we want to say to improve this lower bound of 3n is we want to eliminate more than 3 gates each time, or on average. But we cannot eliminate 4 gates. So we need to keep track of, we want to say that if we eliminate 3 gates, then we at least make circuit nicer in some other way. So for this, we keep track of 4 parameters in our gate elimination. proof. We count the number of inputs the function depends on, the number of gates, the number of this temporary quadratic substitutions that we will make linear by the end of our proof, and also the number of bottleneck gates, where bottleneck gate is a specific configuration that annoys us the most during gate elimination. This is a configuration when we cannot eliminate more than three gates. But what is good about bottleneck gate is that when you eliminate bottleneck gate, you at least eliminate bottleneck gate. So you decrease the complexity measure at least by this much. And the constants are just solution to some linear program. It's not like we were trying to guess constants. Okay, this is the three main ingredients that let us prove a slightly stronger Lower bound. So I just want to conclude with one slide on follow-up works. So in this work, we show that affine dispersers can prove slightly stronger Lower bound. Then we also know that quadratic dispersers would give a very simple proof of 3.1 and Lower bound. But unfortunately, we don't know explicit constructions of quadratic dispersers. We don't know if they belong to NP, for example. If we take even stronger dispersers, like dispersers for restrictions of large constant or even polynomial degrees, then this would prove even superlinear lower bounds in some weaker models, like serious parallel circuits or circuits of log depth. And the natural question to ask is if, yeah, would strong, like really strong dispersers allow us to prove a superlinear lower bound in this general model? And unfortunately, the answer is no. Now we know that even if you have like incredibly strong disperser, you cannot hope to prove even a lower bound of 5n. Okay, so to conclude, these techniques allowed us to improve a lower bound of 3n by a little bit. Now we know that these methods will never lead to a lower bound even of 5n, and this means that this line of research really needs new techniques. I just wanted to thank you for your attention.
Okay, so any questions?
Yeah, we can show that if you use gate elimination as we know it now, then even if you have like extremely strong dispersor for equations of polynomial degree, still you cannot even prove a lower bound of 5n. We can construct a function such that whatever substitutions you make, like you can always eliminate at most 5 gates. So this gate elimination as we know it now, I cannot prove this lower bound even for very strong dispersors.
So you said that for log depth linear size circuits, you can get lower bound for high degree dispersors?
If we have a dispersor of for really high degree, then yeah, this immediately applies a superlinear lower bound.
So would that mean that let's say you can separate NP from linear size log depth?
I mean, if we had these dispersors in NP.
So you don't even know that it's in
NP. We don't even know if quadratic dispersors are in NP yet.
Yeah. No, I'm not talking about
NP, yeah.
And sigma 2?
No, I don't know. Sigma 2x, for sure. But yeah, sure. Sorry, I can't hear you.
Are they affine?
Yeah, they're in P. Yeah. Yeah.
How high a degree would you need to handle to get the linear lower bound
for log depth? For log depths, you need polynomial degrees, like n to the epsilon. For superlinear lower bound against serious parallel circuit, it's enough to have dispersers for large constant degree. That depends. Oh, for quadratic dispersors, we need almost any little O of n would work. Any other questions?
Can you explain where the three gates come from? Like, why is three the magic number?
Oh, yeah, just like when you look at this gate elimination, this is the best you can do. I mean, this is the ideal situation when you can assign something and you kill one gate, like, and the other gate with the gate forces. And that's it. Like, I mean, yeah, when you look at a circuit of finite two, it's not clear how to eliminate more than these three.